I am reading about ISO 9001 2015 standard. I am reading the complete standard, which includes total 10 sections. If you play this video during your leisure time or while going to any audit, this will help you to manage your time, and you can utilize your travel time or your leisure time instead of listening some songs or else other things. Okay, yeah, I'm straightly going into the standard. I'm starting to read the standard. Okay, thank you. Please subscribe my channel and do like us. Thank you. Yeah, quality management systems requirements, ISO 9001 2015, first section number 1 is scope. This international standard specifies requirements for a quality management system when an organization 1 needs to demonstrate its ability to consistently provide products and services that meet customer and applicable statutory and regulatory requirements, and second point, aims to enhance customer satisfaction through the effective application of the system, including process for improvement of the system and the assurance of the conformity to customer and applicable statutory and regulatory requirements. All the requirements of this international standard are generic and are intended to be applicable to any organization regardless of its type or size of the products and services it provides. There is a note 1 here. Note 1 is, in this international standard, the term product or service only applies to products and services intended for or required by a customer. And note 2 is, statutory and regulatory requirements can be expressed as legal requirements. Yeah. Section 2 is normative references. The following documents in whole or in part are normatively referenced in this document and are indispensable for its application. For dated references, only the edition cited applies. For undated references, the latest edition of the reference document applies. Yeah. Third section, terms and definitions. For the purpose of this document, the terms and definitions are given in the ISO 9000:2015 applies. Yeah, they are given separately. I will read in the next video. So, going to the section 4, context of the organization. Section 4, there is a subsection 4.1. 4.1 is understanding the organization of its and its context. The organization shall determine external and internal issues that are relevant to its purpose and its strategic direction, and that affects its ability to achieve the intended result of its quality management system. The organization shall monitor and review information about these external and internal issues. Note 1. Issues can include positive and negative factors or conditions for consideration. Note 2. Understanding the external context can be facilitated by considering issues arising from legal, technological, competitive, market, cultural, social and economic environments, whether international, national, regional or local. Note 3. Understanding the internal context can be facilitated by considering issues related to values, culture, knowledge and performance of the organization. Understanding the needs and expectations of the interested parties. Due to their effect or potential effect on the organization's ability to consistently provide products and services that meet customer and applicable statutory and regulatory requirements, the organization shall determine the interested parties that are relevant to the quality management system, the requirements of these interested parties that are relevant to the quality management system, and the organization shall monitor and review information about these interested parties and their relevant requirements. 4.3. Determining the scope of the quality management system. The organization shall determine the boundaries and applicability of the quality management system to establish its scope. When determining this scope, the organization shall consider the external and internal issues referred to in, as mentioned in 4.1, and the requirements of relevant interested parties referred to as mentioned in 4.2, the products and services of the organization. The organization shall apply all the requirements of this international standard if they are applicable within the determined scope of its quality management system. The scope of this organization's quality management system shall be available and be maintained as documented information. The scope shall state the types of the products and services covered and provide justification for any requirement of this international standard that the organization determines is not applicable to the scope of its quality management system. Conformity to this international standard may only be claimed if the requirements determined as not being applicable do not affect the organization's ability or responsibility to ensure the conformity of its products and services and the enhancement of customer satisfaction. 4.4 Quality Management System and its process. 4.4.1 The organization shall establish, implement, maintain, and continually improve a quality management system, including the process needed and their interactions in accordance with the requirements of this international standard. The organization shall determine the process needed for the quality management system and their application throughout the organization and shall determine the inputs required and the outputs expected from the process. Determine the sequence and interaction of the process. Determine and apply the criteria and methods, including monitoring, measurements, and related performance indicators needed to ensure the effective operation and control of the processes. Determine the resources needed for the processes and ensure their availability. Assign the responsibilities and authorities for these processes. Address the risks and opportunities as determined in accordance with the requirements of Section 6.1. Evaluate these processes and implement any changes needed to ensure that these processes achieve their intended results. And improve the process and the quality management system. 4.4.2 To the extent necessary, the organization shall maintain documented information to support the operation of its processes and to retain the documented information to have confidence that the processes are being carried out as planned. Leadership 5.1 Leadership Leadership and Commitment 5.1.1 General. Top management shall demonstrate leadership and commitment with respect to the quality management system by taking accountability for the effectiveness of the quality management system, ensuring that the quality policy and quality objectives are established for the quality management system and are compatible with the context and strategic direction of the organization. Ensuring the integration of the quality management system requirements into the organization's business process. Promoting the use of the process approach and risk-based thinking. Ensuring that the resources needed for the quality management system are available. Communicating the importance of effective quality management and of conforming to the quality management system requirements. Ensuring that the quality management system achieves its intended results. Engaging, directing, and supporting persons to contribute to the effectiveness of the quality management system. Promoting improvement. Supporting other relevant management roles to demonstrate their leadership as it applies to their areas of responsibility. There is a note here. References to business in this international standard can be interpreted broadly to mean those activities that are core to the purposes of the organization's existence, whether the organization is public, private, or profit or not for profit. Section 5.1 Customer Focus. Top management shall demonstrate leadership and commitment with respect to customer focus by ensuring that customer and applicable statutory and regulatory requirements are determined, understood, and consistently met. The risks and opportunities that can affect conformity of products and services and the ability to enhance customer satisfaction are determined and addressed. The focus on enhancing customer satisfaction is maintained. Yeah. 5.2 policy. 5.2.1 establishing the quality policy. Top management shall establish, implement and maintain a quality policy that is appropriate to the purpose and context of the organization and support its strategic direction, provides a framework for setting quality objectives, includes a commitment to satisfy applicable requirements, includes a commitment to continual improvement of the quality management system. 5.2.2 Communicating the quality policy. The quality policy shall be available and be maintained as documented information, be communicated, understood and applied within the organization, be available to relevant interested parties as appropriate. 5.3 Organization roles, responsibilities and authorities. Top management shall ensure that the responsibilities and authorities for relevant roles are assigned, communicated and understood within the organization. Top management shall assign the responsibility and authority for ensuring that the quality management system conforms to the requirements of this international standard, ensuring that the processes are delivering their intended outputs, reporting on the performance of the quality management system and on opportunities for improvement, in particular to top management, ensuring the promotion of the customer focus throughout the organization, ensuring that the integrity of the quality management system is maintained when changes to the quality management system are planned and implemented. Now going to section 6. 6 is planning. 6.1 Actions to address risks and opportunities. 6.1.1 When planning for the quality management system, the organization shall consider the issues referred to in section 4.1 and the requirements referred to in section 4.2 and determine the risks and opportunities that need to be addressed to give assurance that the quality management system can achieve its intended results, can enhance desirable effects, prevent or reduce undesirable effects, achieve improvement. The organization shall plan actions to address these risks and opportunities, how to integrate and implement the actions into its quality management system process, evaluate the effectiveness of these actions. Actions taken to address risks and opportunities shall be proportionate to the potential impact on the conformity of products and services. 6.2 Quality objectives and planning to achieve them. 6.2.1 The organization shall establish quality objectives at relevant functions, levels and processes needed for the quality management system. The quality objectives shall be consistent with the quality policy, shall be measurable, take into account applicable requirements, be relevant to conformity of products and services, to enhance customer satisfaction, be monitored, be communicated, be updated as appropriate. The organization shall maintain documented information on the quality objectives. 6.2.2 When planning how to achieve its quality objectives, the organization shall determine what will be done, what resources will be required, who will be responsible, when it will be completed, how the results will be evaluated. 6.3 Planning of changes. When the organization determines the need for changes to the quality management system, the changes shall be carried out in a planned manner. See section 4.4. Sorry. The organization shall consider the purpose of the changes and their potential consequences, the integrity of the quality management system, the availability of the resources, the allocation or reallocation of responsibilities and authorities. Section 7 Support. 7.1 Resources. 7.1.1 General. The organization shall determine and provide the resources needed for the establishment, implementation, maintenance, and continual improvement of the quality management system. The organization shall consider the capabilities of and constraints on existing internal resources, what needs to be maintained from external providers. 7.1.2 People. The organization shall determine and provide the persons necessary for the effective implementation of its quality management system and for the operation and control of its processes. 7.1.3 Infrastructure. The organization shall determine, provide and maintain the infrastructure necessary for the operation of its processes and to achieve conformity of products and services. 7.1.4 Infrastructure can include buildings and associated utilities, equipment including hardware and software, transportation resources, information and communication technology. 7.1.4 Environment for the operation of the process. The organization shall determine, provide and maintain the environment necessary for the operation of its process and to achieve conformity of products and services. 7.1.5 Monitoring and measuring resources. 7.1.5.1 General. The organization shall determine and provide the resources needed to ensure valid and reliable results when monitoring or measuring is used to verify the conformity of products and services to the requirements. The organization shall ensure that the resources provided are suitable for the specific type of monitoring and measurement activities being undertaken and are maintained to ensure their continuing fitness for their purpose. The organization shall retain appropriate documented information as evidence of fitness for purpose of the monitoring and measurement resources. 7.1.5.2 Measurement traceability. When measurement traceability is a requirement or is considered by the organization to be an essential part of providing confidence in the validity of measurement results, measuring equipment shall be calibrated or verified or both at specified intervals or prior to use against measurement standards traceable to the international or national measurement standards when no such standards exist. The basis used for calibration or verification shall be retained as documented information identified in order to determine their status, safeguarded from adjustments, damage or deterioration that would invalidate the calibration status and subsequent measurement results. The organization shall determine if the validity of the previous measurement and results have been adversely affected when measuring equipment is found to be unfit for its intended purpose and shall take appropriate actions as necessary. 7.1.6 Organizational knowledge. The organization shall determine the knowledge necessary for the operation of its process and to achieve conformity of products and services. This knowledge shall be maintained and be made available to the extent necessary. When addressing changing needs and trends, the organization shall consider its current knowledge and determine how to acquire or access any necessary additional knowledge and required updates. 7.2 Competence. The organization shall determine the necessary competence of persons doing work under its control that affects the performance and effectiveness of the quality management system. Ensure that these persons are competent on the basis of appropriate education, training or experience. Where applicable, take actions to acquire the necessary competence and evaluate the effectiveness of the actions taken. Retain appropriate documented information as evidence of competence. 7.3 Awareness. The organization shall ensure that persons doing work under the organization's control are aware of the quality policy, relevant quality objectives, their contribution to the effectiveness of the quality management system, including the benefits of the improved performance, the implications of not conforming with the quality management system requirements. 7.4 Communication. The organization shall determine the internal and external communications relevant to the quality management system, including on what it will communicate, when to communicate, with whom to communicate, how to communicate, who communicates. 7.5 Documented information. 7.5.1 General. The organization's quality management system shall include documented information required by this international standard, documented information determined by the organization as being necessary for the effectiveness of the quality management system. The complexity of process and their interactions, the competence of the persons. 7.5.2 Creating and updating. When creating and updating the documented information, the organization shall ensure appropriate identification and description. Example, title, date, author or reference number. Format and media. Review and approval for suitability and adequacy. 7.5.3 Control of documented information. 7.5.3.1 Documented information required by the quality management system and by this international standard shall be controlled to ensure it is available and suitable for use where and when it is needed. It is adequately protected. 7.5.3.2 For the control of the documented information, the organization shall address the following activities as applicable. Distribution, access, retrieval and use. Storage and preservation, including preservation of legibility, control of changes, retention and disposition. Documented information of external origin determined by the organization to be necessary for the planning and operation of the quality management system shall be identified as appropriate and be controlled. Documented information retained as evidence of conformity shall be protected from unintended alterations. Next section is 8. Operations. 8.1 Operational planning and control. The organization shall plan, implement and control the process, see section 4.1, needed to meet the requirements for the provision of products and services and to implement the actions determined in clause 6 by determining the requirements for the products and services or establishing the criteria for the process of the acceptance of products and services. Third point, determining the resources needed to achieve conformity to the products and service requirements. Implementing control of the process in accordance with the criteria, determining, maintaining and retaining documented information to the extent necessary. To have confidence that the process have been carried out as planned and to demonstrate the conformity of products and services to their requirements. The output of this planning shall be suitable for the organization's operations. The organization shall control planned changes and review the consequences of unintended changes, taking action to mitigate any adverse effects as necessary. The organization shall ensure that outsourced processes are controlled. 8.2 Requirements for products and services. 8.2.1 Customer communication. Communication with customers shall include providing information relating to products and services, handling inquiries, contracts or orders including changes, obtaining customer feedback relating to the products and services, including customer complaints, handling or controlling customer property, establishing specific requirements for contingency actions when relevant. 8.2.2 Determining the requirements for products and services. When determining the requirements for the products and services to be offered to the customers, the organization shall ensure that the requirements for the products and services are defined, including any applicable statutory and regulatory requirements, those considered necessary by the organization, and the organization can meet the claims for the products and services it offers. 8.2.3 Review of the requirements for products and services. 8.2.3.1 The organization shall ensure that it has the ability to meet the requirements for products and services to be offered to customers. The organization shall conduct a review before committing to supply products and services to a customer to include requirements specified by the customer, including the requirement for delivery and post-delivery activities, requirements not stated by the customer but necessary for the specified or intended use when known, requirements specified by the organization, statutory and regulatory requirements applicable to the products and services, contract or order requirements differing from those previously expressed. The organization shall ensure that contract or order requirements differing from those previously defined are resolved. The customer's requirements shall be confirmed by the organization before acceptance when the customer does not provide a documented statement of their requirements. 8.2.3.2. The organization shall retain documented information as applicable on the results of the review on any new requirements for the products and services. 8.2.4. Changes to the requirements for products and services. The organization shall ensure that relevant documented information is amended and that relevant persons are made aware of the changed requirements when the requirements for products and services are changed. 8.3. Design and development of products and services. 8.3.1. General. The organization shall ensure that shall establish, implement and maintain a design and development process that is appropriate to ensure that subsequent provision of products and services. 8.3.2. Design and development planning. In determining the stages and controls for design and development, the organization shall consider the nature, duration and complexity of the design and development activities, the required process stages including applicable design and development reviews, the required design and development verification and validation activities, the responsibilities and authorities involved in the design and development process, the internal and external resource needs for the design and development of the products and services, the need to control interfaces between the persons involved in the design and development process, the need for involvement of customers and users in the design and development process, the requirements for subsequent provision of products and services, the level of control expected for the design and development process by customers and other relevant interested parties, the documented information needed to demonstrate that design and development requirements have been met. 8.3.3. Design and development inputs. The organization shall determine the requirements essential for the specific types of the products and the services to be designed and developed. The organization shall consider functional and performance requirements, information derived from the previous similar design and development activities, statutory and regulatory requirements, standards or codes or practice that the organization has committed to implement, potential consequences of failure due to the nature of the products and services. Input shall be adequate for design and development purposes, complete and unambiguous. Conflicting design and development input shall be resolved. The organization shall retain documented information on design and development inputs. 8.3.4. Design and development controls. The organization shall apply controls to the design and development process to ensure that the results to be achieved are defined. Reviews are conducted to evaluate the ability of the results and of design and development to meet the requirements. Verification activities are conducted to ensure that the design and development outputs meet the input requirements. Validation activities are conducted to ensure that the resulting products and services meet the requirements for the specified application or intended use. Any necessary actions are taken on problems determined during the reviews or verification and validation activities. Documented information of these activities is retained. 8.3.5. Design and development outputs. The organization shall ensure that design and development outputs meet the input requirements and are adequate for the subsequent process for the provision of products and services, include our reference monitoring and measuring requirements as appropriate and acceptance criteria, specify the characteristics of the products and services that are essential for their intended purpose and their safe and proper provision. The organization shall retain documented information on design and development outputs. 8.3.6. Design and development changes. The organization shall identify, review and control changes made during or subsequent to the design and development of products and services to the extent necessary to ensure that there is no adverse impact on conformity to the requirements. The organization shall retain documented information on design and development changes, the results of reviews, the authority of changes, the actions taken to prevent adverse impacts. Control of externally provided processes, products and services, that is section 8.4. 8.4.1 is general. The organization shall ensure that externally provided processes, products and services conform to the requirements. The organization shall determine the controls to be applied to externally provided processes, products and services when products and services from external providers are intended for incorporation into the organization's own products and services. Products and services are provided directly to the customers by external providers on behalf of the organization. A process or part of process is provided by an external provider as a result of a decision by the organization. The organization shall determine and apply criteria for the evaluation, selection, monitoring of the performance and re-evaluation of the external providers based on their ability to provide processes or products and services in accordance with the requirements. The organization shall retain documented information of these activities and any necessary actions arising from the evaluations. 8.4.2 Type and extent of control. The organization shall ensure that externally provided process, products and services do not adversely affect the organization's ability to consistently deliver conforming products and services to its customers. The organization shall ensure that externally provided processes remain within the control of its quality management system. Define both the controls that it intends to apply to an external provider and those it intends to apply to the resulting output. Type and extent of control. The organization shall ensure that externally provided processes and products and services do not adversely affect the organization's ability to consistently deliver conforming products and services to its customers. The organization shall ensure that externally provided processes remain within the control of its quality management system. Define both the controls that it intends to apply to an external provider and those it intends to apply to the resulting output. Take into consideration the potential impact of the external provided process, products and services on the organization's ability to consistently meet customer and applicable statutory and regulatory requirements, the effectiveness of the controls applied by the external provider. Determine the verification or other activities necessary to ensure that the externally provided process, products and services meets requirements. 8.4.3 Information for external providers. The organization shall ensure the adequacy of requirements prior to their communication to the external provider. The organization shall communicate to the external providers its requirements for the process, products and services to be provided. The approval of products and services, methods, process and equipment, the release of the products and services, competence including any required qualifications of persons, the external providers' interactions with the organization, control and monitoring of the external providers' performance to be applied by the organization, verification or validation activities that the organization or its customer intends to perform at the external provider's premises. 8.5 Production service provision. Production and service provision. 8.5.1 Control of production and service provision. The organization shall implement production service provision under controlled conditions. Controlled conditions shall include as applicable the availability of documented information that defines the characteristics of the products to be produced, the services to be provided or the activities to be performed, the results to be achieved. The availability and the use of the suitable monitoring and measuring resources, the implementation of monitoring and measurement activities at appropriate stages to verify that criteria for control of process or outputs and acceptance criteria for products and services have been met. The use of suitable infrastructure and environment for the operation of the process, the appointment of competent persons including any required qualification, the validation of competent persons including any required qualification, the validation and periodic revalidation of the ability to achieve planned results of the process for production service provision where the resulting output cannot be verified by subsequent monitoring or measurement. The implementation of actions to prevent human error, the implementation of release, delivery and post-delivery activities. 8.5.2 Identification and Traceability. The organization shall use suitable means to identify outputs when it is necessary to ensure the conformity of products and services. The organization shall identify the status of the outputs with respect to monitoring and measurement requirements throughout the production and service provision. The organization shall control the unique identification of the outputs when traceability is a requirement and shall retain the documented information necessary to enable traceability. 8.5.3 Property belonging to customers or external providers. The organization shall exercise care with the property belonging to the customers or external providers while it is under the organization's control or being used by the organization. The organization shall identify, verify, protect and safeguard customers or external providers' property provided for use or for incorporation into the products and services. When the property of a customer or external provider is lost, damaged or otherwise found to be unsuitable for use, the organization shall report this to the customer or external provider and retain documented information on what has occurred. 8.5.4 Preservation. The organization shall preserve the outputs during the production and service provision to the extent necessary to ensure conformity to the requirements. 8.5.5 Post-delivery activities. The organization shall meet the requirements for the post-delivery activities associated with the products and services. In determining the extent of the post-delivery activities that are required, the organization shall consider statutory and regulatory requirements, the potential undesired consequences associated with its products and services, the nature, use and intended lifetime of its products and services, customer requirements, customer feedback. 8.5.6 Control of changes. The organization shall review and control changes for production or service provision to the extent necessary to ensure continuing conformity with the requirements. The organization shall retain documented information describing the results of the review of the changes, the persons authorizing the change and any necessary actions arising from the review. 8.6 Release of products and services. The organization shall implement planned arrangements at appropriate stages to verify that the products and service requirements have been met. The release of the products and services to the customer shall not proceed until the planned arrangements have been satisfactorily completed unless otherwise approved by a relevant authority and as applicable by the customer. The organization shall retain documented information on the release of the products and services, and the documented information shall include evidence of conformity with the acceptance criteria, traceability of the persons authorizing the release. 8.7 Control of non-conforming outputs. 8.7.1 The organization shall ensure that the outputs that do not conform to the requirements are identified and controlled to prevent their unintended use or delivery. The organization shall take appropriate action based on the nature of the non-conformity and its effect on the conformity of the products and services. This shall also apply to non-conforming products and services detected after delivery of the products, during or after the provision of the services. The organization shall deal with the non-conforming outputs in one or more of the following ways. Correction, segregation, containment, return or suspension of provision of products and services, informing the customer, obtaining authorization for acceptance under concession. Conformity to the requirement shall be verified when non-conforming outputs are corrected. The organization shall retain documented information that describes the non-conformity, describes the actions taken, describes any concessions obtained, identify the authority deciding the action in respect of the non-conformity. Now, section 9, last but one section, performance evaluation, section 9. 9.1, monitoring, measurement, analysis and evaluation. 9.1.1, general. The organization shall determine what needs to be monitored and measured, the methods for monitoring, measurement, analysis and evaluation needed to ensure valid results. When the monitoring and measurement shall be performed, when the results from monitoring and measurement shall be analyzed and evaluated, the organization shall evaluate the performance and the effectiveness of the quality management system, and the organization shall retain appropriate documented information as evidence of the results. Customer satisfaction. The organization shall monitor customers' perception of the degree to which their needs and expectations have been fulfilled. The organization shall determine the methods for obtaining, monitoring and reviewing this information. 9.1.3, analysis and evaluation. The organization shall analyze and evaluate appropriate data and information arising from monitoring and measurement. The results of analysis shall be used to evaluate conformity of products and services, the degree of customer satisfaction, the performance and effectiveness of the quality management system, if planning has been implemented effectively, the effectiveness of actions taken to address risks and opportunities, the performance of the external providers, the need for improvements to the quality management system. 9.2, internal audit. 9.2.1, the organization shall conduct internal audits planned at intervals to provide information on whether the quality management system conforms to the organization's own requirements for its quality management system and the requirements of this international standard. And the second point is effectively implemented and maintained. 9.2.2, the organization shall plan, establish, implement and maintain an audit program including the frequency, methods, responsibilities, planning requirements and reporting, which shall take into consideration the importance of the process concerned, changes affecting the organization and the results of the previous audits. Second point, define the audit criteria and scope for each audit. 3. Select auditors and conduct audits to ensure objectivity and the impartiality of the audit process. 4. Ensure that the results of the audits are reported to relevant management. 5. Take appropriate correction and corrective actions without undue delay. Retain documented information as evidence of the implementation of the audit program and the audit results. 9.3, management review. 9.3.1, general. Top management shall review the organization's quality management system at planned intervals to ensure its continuing suitability, adequacy, effectiveness and alignment with the strategic direction of the organization. 9.3.2, management review inputs. The management review shall be planned and carried out taking into consideration the status of the actions from previous management reviews, the changes in the external and internal issues that are relevant to the quality management system, the information on the performance and effectiveness of the quality management system, including trends in the customer satisfaction and feedback from relevant interested parties, including the extent to which quality objectives have been met, including process performance and conformity of products and services, including non-conformities and corrective actions, including monitoring and measurement results, including audit results, including the performance of the external providers, including the adequacy of resources, including the effectiveness of the actions taken to address risks and opportunities, including the opportunities for improvement. 9.3.3, management review outputs. The outputs of the management review shall include decisions and actions related to the opportunities for improvement, any need for changes to the quality management system, resource needs, The organization shall retain documented information as evidence of the results of the management reviews. Last section 10, improvement 10.1, general. The organization shall determine and select opportunities for improvement and implement any necessary actions to meet customer requirements and enhance customer satisfaction. These shall include improving products and services to meet requirements as well as to address future needs and expectations, correcting, preventing or reducing the undesired effects, and improving the performance and effectiveness of the quality management system. 10.2 Non-conformity and corrective action. 10.2.1 When a non-conformity occurs, including any arising from complaints, the organization shall react to the non-conformity and, as applicable, take action to control and correct it, deal with the consequences. 2. Evaluate the need for the action to eliminate the cause of the non-conformity in order that it does not recur or occur elsewhere by reviewing and analyzing the non-conformity, determining the causes of the non-conformity, determining if similar non-conformities exist or could potentially occur. Third point is implement any action needed. Fourth point is review the effectiveness of any corrective action taken. Fifth point is update risks and opportunities determined during planning if necessary. And sixth point is make changes to the quality management system if necessary. Corrective action shall be appropriate to the efforts of the non-conformities encountered. 10.2.2 The organization shall retain documented information as evidence of the nature of the non-conformities and any subsequent actions taken. And second point is the results of any corrective action. 10.3 Continual improvement. The organization shall continually improve the suitability, adequacy and effectiveness of the quality management system. The organization shall consider the results of the analysis and evaluation and the output from the management review to determine if there are needs or opportunities that shall be addressed as part of the continual improvement. Over. So, ISO 9001:2015 standard. This is the complete standard which includes all the 10 sections. If possible, in my next video, I will try to explain the main chapter wise. I will explain slowly in my next videos. Please subscribe our channel and do like us if you like this video. And if any comments are there or feedback is there from your side, please kindly mention in the bottom box. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much.